Number 1. Montmartre is a district in the 18th arrondissement in Paris, famous for the artistic vibes and the iconic landmark Sacré Cœur Basilica. Number 2. The spectacular white basilica is a memorial to the French soldiers killed during the Franco-Prussian War. Number 3. By the end of the 19th century, it was a popular working-class residential area, and the low living cost was a magnet for the artists and writers, including Matisse and Picasso. Number 4. Place du Tertre is supposedly the highest point in Paris. In the 19th century, artists used to exhibit paintings here. Today, it's still full of street artists and cozy cafes. Number 5. Montmartre has appeared in many movies, but Emily by Jean-Pierre captured all the charms of this district. The cobblestone streets, small grocery stores, the old merry-go-round below Sacré Cœur. The cafe Emily worked in the movie still exists, the Café de Dumoulin, with very similar setting as in the movie. Number 6. Montmartre was once a village outside Paris, dotted with windmills. Two of them still remain today, Moulin Bluffon and Moulin Hardet, on the same street. You may get the gist of how it looked like back then from Picasso's painting. The two windmills are also where the name of Café de Dumoulin comes from. Number 7. This very cute pink house is arguably the most Instagrammed house in Montmartre. It has been opened for over 100 years. After Laura Germain bought the cafe in 1905, she painted it into pink color, inspired by a visit to Barcelona. Oh, by the way, she had been the muse of Picasso for a long time, and Picasso, among other artists, were common guests in the cafe. Today, La Maison Rose takes on a fresh look after the renovation completed in 2018. It appeared in the American Netflix series Emily in Paris. Number 8. It may be surprising there is a vineyard in the middle of all the pretty houses, and you may think this is another nostalgia remain from the 19th century. Well, you may be disappointed. Interestingly, the vineyard was created by the city of Paris in 1933 to stop real estate developers from purchasing the land. Every year, the Club Montmartre wines are auctioned with the revenue funding projects in the district. People often joke, it's the most expensive poor quality wine in Paris. Number 9. Wall of Love with the phrase I love you in 250 languages. It comes from a personal endeavor of Frederick Baron started in 1992. He spent years wandering Paris and connecting with people from all over the world to collect how they express I love you. Sometimes, he even knocked down the doors of the embassies to verify. Today, this place is often used for proposal. Cliché or not, you be the judge. Number 10. Au Lapin Agile. In the early 20th century, this nightclub used to be a popular meeting place for the artists. Picasso's painting depicts the interior of it. Today, the cabaret still remains its original atmosphere. Music and shows start from 9 p.m. to early morning, and it's a great experience for a taste of the golden age of Paris. Number 11. When at Sacré Cœur, look for the orange house behind the hill. If you tilt your camera, it will look like it's sinking from the side. Number 12. If you don't want to climb the stairs to Sacré Cœur, there's actually a train to take you up in only 90 seconds. The price is the same as the metro ticket. Montmartre is one of my favorite places in Paris. I can spend a whole afternoon here and just chill. I hope you find this video helpful and enjoy Montmartre as I do. Till next time.